In this tutorial, I will show you a game that's called Gun Battle. This is the info screen. We can see here which buttons we can use to play the game. It's a simple game where we have two tanks throwing shells to each other. This one is the user's tank, and this one is controlled by the computer. We only have to choose the power and the angle, and then shoot a shell. But there is also a random factor here, the wind speed, that changes after each turn. Okay, if there is a win, this is the win screen that appears for a couple of seconds, and we can see the score updated. The state diagram that controls the flow of the game is shown here. We start at the show info screen, and then pressing any key will take us to the game. We can play the game then. If there is a win, the show winner screen appears for a couple of seconds, and then we return to the game. By pressing N, we can start a new round, while pressing R resets the score and takes us back to the show info screen. So let's have a look at the code. Here we have the creation of the frame, and we set the draw handler, a key up handler, and the key down handler. These are needed to detect which keys the user press. The update timer is a timer that calls the update function, and this function actually updates the position of the cell on the screen, and the velocity and the acceleration. So let's see how the game is controlled. This is the key down function that detects the keystrokes. So if we are at the show info screen and we press any key, then the function new game is called. So new game resets everything and starts a new round. In a new round, we set the visibility of both tanks to be true. We close the show info screen and we start the timer, the update timer. Finally, it calls next turn so that the game can begin. The next turn function starts a new turn. Initially, it randomly selects a new value for the wind speed and sets this value as the first component of the acceleration. If this is not the first round and we already have started the game, this function changes the turn. So if it was human's turn, now it will be computer's turn, and vice versa. If it is an entirely new game, then the turn is chosen randomly between the human and the computer. And finally, if it is a computer's turn, the program plays for the computer, of course, and we choose a random angle and a random power and shoot a cell. So, let's look what happens when the update function is called. The update function initially checks to see if the cell hit a tank. If there is a hit on the human tank, then we make both the cell and the human tank invisible, and we denote that the winner is computer. If the cell hits the computer tank, we make the cell and the computer invisible and denote that the winner is human. And after that, we call the game over function that just updates the score and shows the winner screen for a couple of seconds before we can continue with the game. If nothing of this is true, then we have to update the position of the cell on the screen. Here, we compute the time that has passed since the last update. We need to have the time passed in seconds so that our formulas work correctly. We update the position and the velocity of the cell using these formulas right here. The new position will be incremented by the velocity times the time passed, and the new velocity will be incremented by the acceleration times the time passed. And actually, we can see that in this code over here, the time factor is just a constant that is used to speed things up so that the simulation is not too slow. Since we have updated the values, we check if the cell is out of the canvas bounds. If the cell goes out of the screen, we call next round so that the other player can have his turn. So this is the update function. And let's have a look at the draw function that draws everything on the screen. This code right here just draws the human and the computer tank if they should be drawn, okay? If H visible is true and if C visible is true. After that, we draw the ground. And finally, we draw the score. Now, if this is a new game and the show info screen is visible, we draw nothing else and return, which means we exit the draw function. If this is not the case and we have a winner, then we draw the winner on the canvas. If nothing of this is true, then we check to see whose turn it is right now. If it is the human's turn, we call this function over here that draws the wind at the side of the human. And this function here draws the wind at the side of the computer. I have chosen to draw the wind at either side to make it more clear whose turn it is right now. And of course, if there is a cell fired, we draw the cell. Okay? These functions over here draw everything on the screen. Let's have a look at the draw winner function. The draw winner function simply draws a text message at the middle of the screen saying who won the last round and starts the winner timer. This timer, after 2 seconds, will fire an event that will cause the show winner off function to be called. This function sets the show winner variable to false so that the next time the draw function will be called, it won't draw the show winner screen, and stops the timer. And of course, finally, it calls next round so that we can return to the game. Here we have some helper functions. This function over here is the function that is called whenever the computer has to choose an angle. So the angle is randomly chosen between min angle and max angle. And the same happens for the power. This function is called when the computer needs to randomly select the power of its next shot. The compute velocity function is used to compute the velocity vector. We have a cell that is shot with velocity, initial velocity v, okay, and we have to compute the horizontal component and the vertical component of the velocity. So if the cell is shot at an angle of 8 degrees, okay, the horizontal component, the vx, will be v times cosine of a, and of course the vertical component will be v times sine of a, and this exactly is computed right here. The endpoint function simply computes the coordinates of the edge of the cannon so that we can tell which are the initial coordinates of the cell. The fire function initializes a shot. If it is the human's turn, then we choose the cannon to be the human cannon, the power to be that of the human, the angle and so on, okay, the color that is used to draw the cell, and the direction is from left to right, okay. I remind you here that this is a constant which has the value of 1 for the human, for the right, okay, for the right, and the left means minus 1. Then this function calls the endpoint function to compute the initial coordinates of the cell, which means the edge of the cannon. This will be the initial coordinates for a cell that is fired from a human cannon, and this will be the initial coordinates for a cell fired from the computer's cannon. Then we compute the velocity vector given the power, okay, the angle and the direction of the shot. We set the cell to be visible so that it gets drawn on the screen, and of course this variable here denotes that the cell's color will be equal to the color of the human or the computer respectively, depending on whose turn it is right now. Finally, the heat function checks to see if the cell has hit the given tank.